Good afternoon to you all from Colombo. And this episode of our webinar series will be based on University of Leicester in the UK. And we have the regional representative of the university connected with us today. Good afternoon, Ms. Srijita. Please give us an introduction to University of Leicester.
So, hi everyone, I'm Srijita Datta. So I'm representing University of Leicester for UCOL. So basically coming to University of Leicester, it's quite an old university. It's around, it completed 100 years this year. And it's quite a reputed university of UK, ranking around amongst 25th in UK and having a diverse culture and everything. So it's a very good city to visit. It's a very good place to, you know, have your studies further. And that's it I can say about Leicester, and we can see about University of Leicester throughout the presentation, basically. So you'll have a good idea of what the university has to offer to you.
Oh, right. Let's continue with the presentation.
Okay. So this is basically the university. So it's around 100 years old. So it traces its past from the World War I. And so basically it's founded in 1921. It's home to around 15,000 students and around 30 departments are there, which is divided into three various colleges. So basically coming to Leicester, it's around, as I told you, it lies into top 25 best universities in UK. And it has a great reputation for career guidance. There is a very great team for that. So you can see there's 94% employability. It is 21st in the world for sustainability. It has a very good student union. You'll also have a Indian culture there. And it's the third most affordable city. And also Leicester has, you know, TEF silver ranking. Coming to the entry requirements, we have undergraduate as well as postgraduate courses. So we have two intakes, one is September and one is January. So in September, we run both the ones like undergraduate as well as postgraduate. In January, we only have the postgraduate courses running, but a very few of them, not all the courses run in Jan. So coming to the undergraduate requirements, this is basically your Indian requirements. So where we need overall 80%, for the state boards and 75% for ICSE and CBSE boards. Coming to Sri Lanka, entry requirement as per 80%, I think it will be AA and AB. So that would be your requirement. And for postgraduate, you need to have 60% in your bachelor's. English requirements, we accept ILSPT, Duolingo, TOEFL, and there are many more. So if you go to the site of University of Leicester, you can see what are the English language tests that we accept. But being these three, the popular ones, I can discuss the requirements for these. So basically for IELTS, when we are going to say informatics or engineering, most of the courses will require 6 with no less than 5.5. And a few of the courses like mechanical engineering with management and engineering management, that would require 6.5 with no less than 5.5. For business-based courses, the flat requirement is 6.5 with no less than 5.5. And you can check the PTE and Duolingo requirements, which is at per the IELTS 6 and 6.5. So for PTE, we need 56 with no less than 51. For business-based courses, it is 61 with no less than 51. For Duolingo, it will be 100 with no less than 90. And for business courses, it will be 110 with no less than 90. This is not applicable to Sri Lanka students. Coming to scholarships, so School of Informatics and School of Engineering is offering you two types of scholarships. That is, from 60% to 65%, they have a different slab of scholarship, that is 22% of the tuition fees. And if you're securing 65% up, so you'll be having a scholarship of 28%. So you don't need to apply for these, but they come directly with you, with your offer. So if you're generally having 65 up, in your bachelor's, you're getting a 28%. And if you're having 60 to 65, you're getting a 22% scholarship. For business courses, for any management-based courses, if you're having 65 plus, you're getting a flat 3,000 scholarship. Again, you don't need to apply for that. Coming to the process is quite easy and it's not very fussy. So basically how we start, so you contact your agent, give them your documents. So the documents is first checked. And then what happens is we process the application. It goes to the university. After that, you wait for the offer letter to come. So offer letter might take you around, right now, as per the situation, it might take you 2 weeks, but normally it takes around 3 to 4 days. It does not take much time for the offer letter to come. So if you're having conditional offer letter, all the conditions will be mentioned in the offer letter. So you can meet those conditions and you can request unconditional offer letter. And if you're getting an unconditional offer letter, you can directly proceed for payment. That is the minimum deposit. So once you proceed for payment, after holding an offer, unconditional offer letter, once it reflects in the university's account, you get to request your CAS, that is confirmation of acceptance of studies. You can request that. Once you get that, you can proceed for your visa filing. So we are not having any credibility interview. We are not having any financial checks. So at least that is for Indian students. And I'm sure that would be pretty similar for the Sri Lankan students as well. So this is the basic process that we follow. Now university have started a new interview. It's a very short interview that they conduct with all the paid students, that they do it for a document check. So nothing else, it's just for a document check. They would be giving a call to the students and then you're good to go. But that has no connection with your CAS, okay? So if you're receiving, you have received your CAS, you can proceed for visa filing. So this is the basic process of how an application runs from application till enrollment. This is the process. These are the few of the popular courses that we run. So we receive maximum amount of application for these courses. So all the engineering based course, especially your engineering management, then you have data analysis. So these courses are very famous courses, even computer science. So these are very famous courses, and engineering management is like mini MBA for engineering students. All right, we are not having MBA. But if you want to go for management, you can go for international management MSc, you have management MSc. And for engineers who want to proceed like an MBA one, it's like a mini MBA to you. So you can always, it's a very good subject. It has good modules. So you can always proceed for that. It has a good career opportunities. And most of the courses under School of Engineering and Informatics comes with industry options. That is, you get to work. You have 1 year is going to be your course, and second year you can focus on your internships and you can focus on your jobs and everything, which you're going to get an assistance from the university side. All right. This is basically a few of the industrial partners who come and, you know, recruit students. So these are the few of them with whom you can start working. So there might be a few of yours role companies. So please have a look. And if you join Leicester, you're going to have quite a good, you know, exposure to these companies. This is how you can reach from University of Leicester, from London to University of Leicester. So you can avail airport taxis, bus, or you can even book Eurostars. So these are basically the basic informations of how much it can charge you and everything. So it's basically 2 hours distance from Leicester to London. And this is how you can avail the transportations. And thank you. So if you're having any questions, you can come up with it. I would try to answer all of them.
Well, thank you so much for the valuable presentation. Before we move into the Q&A, I just have a few more clarifications regarding your uni, and then about the, you know, visa process in general at the moment.
Sure.
So if the student doesn't meet the entry requirement of the university, what are the pathways available?
Pathways, we are not doing any pathways currently. So basically they need to have these qualifications to get into Leicester.
Right. In the case the student has failed his A-levels, can he get in through a foundation program?
We are not doing that at the moment. We are focusing basically, your UG applications happen through UCAS. So if you're having 80%, then you can apply through UCAS and then the process happens. We are not really proceeding for pathways.
How long will the CAS letter take after the student
CAS letter does not take much time. As I told you, Leicester is very fast with their offers and CAS. So normally before, when everything was fine, it used to hardly take 2 to 3 days. Now we can take maximum time to be 2 weeks. So it does not even take that much. So you will get your CAS after, once the payment reflects to university, within 2 weeks, you can expect your CAS.
Right. Okay. So, does University of Leicester have a mid intake, like maybe in like June or July?
No. It's just 2 intakes. That is September and January. September is for both undergraduate and postgraduate, but Jan is only for postgraduate with very less number of courses running.
I see. Okay. So, how much does accommodation cost in campus and outside campus in Leicester?
Accommodation, I won't be able to give you a proper figure. If any student is having that question, you can always mail it to me. I'll revert back in mail.
All right. I believe the bachelor students are also eligible for post-study work period in Sri Lanka. I think that was only given this year. So is there a minimum period of study to be eligible for that?
Normally, bachelors are of 3 years. So if they're taking an industry with that, then it goes as it is. But I think that will be fine for the students.
All right. Okay. How is the current part-time job availability in Leicester currently?
It's going well because, as I told you, that the career guidance is quite well in Leicester. So that's where you have 94% employability. So they have a good set of counselors who guide the students through all the process. And it's going pretty well because many... Even after the pandemic, we are having chunk of students who have gone there and are doing their classes or doing their internships. So it's going pretty well. And as I already showed you, which are the companies which come over there to recruit students, which are there. So it's pretty good situation. It's not that as bad as we are thinking it to be.
Right. Okay. So if the student is bringing a dependent, if it's a master's student, does the dependent need to show matured money when applying for visa?
Visa related questions, I won't be able to answer much because visa, we do not assist.
I see.
But normally, as per what we are doing with our students, if the student can take their dependent and they're filing it along with themselves, so you can do that. And the visa related questions, if you have, you can go to the site once and you can check.
How long is the quarantine period for students in the UK currently, and how much is that going to cost them?
Cost will be approx 2000 GBP. And then you are having a test. I think there are certain days mentioned where you need to get the test done. I think it will be 14 days only.
All right. Okay. So prior to departure from Sri Lanka for students, does the student needs to be vaccinated or just a PCR test is fine?
Nothing like that has come to us. Actually, the rules and all keeps on changing most of the time, but right now we are not having any information on that.
Right. Okay. We have a few questions in the Q&A. So one student is asking if they can apply with their O-level results.
I need to see this and I can get back to you.
All right. Okay. And the next question is IELTS mandatory?
I'll get back to you. Yeah, IELTS will be mandatory because you're not having any waiver system for Sri Lankan students. So it will be mandatory.
Right. Okay. What will be the course fee for bachelor's in management?
Course fee would be, I would check and get back to you because these numbers I'm not having properly. Normally it will be, I think, something around 16, something like that, 16 to 19 in that range. If you're securing a scholarship, then it goes down.
This one student is asking if they can secure the job after the internship, and if so, how long would be the internship period?
It's nothing like internship. We are giving industry. So industry is not internship. So basically what happens is, if anybody chooses, say, 1 year course, all right, and if somebody chooses a course with industry, so your first year will be as so that is it's not right. Internship, and there's no duration of that.
Right. So does University of Leicester offer like sandwich programs where you all have the internship with the offer?
It's not like that. As I'm telling you, it's not internship. It is with industry. So industry is like, if you're choosing it in the second year, you need to pay a certain fees of 3,000 some pounds for that. If you're securing that, it is a paid one. So you need, they basically prepare you for the internship with all everything, CV, grooming, everything goes on into that. So it's a paid thing,
right,
which you can take in the second year.
Understood, ma'am. So how much can I make from part-time work?
Part-time, at the current situation, you mail me these things, I can get back to you with that. Because at the current situation, I won't be able to help you much with it. So you just mail me these questions and I can get back to you.
Right, sure.
Students
sure,
have
all right.
Mail me these. I have given the mail ID, I also share it with you. So they can mail me directly and I can get back to them with the answers and queries.
Noted, ma'am. Okay. So that's the time we have for today. Thank you so much, Ms. Srijita, for your time and this valuable information that you gave. Looking forward to doing more sessions with you in the future. Thank you everyone for joining today. So if you have any further questions, you can connect with one of our counselors through contacting 070-10700-70, or you can connect with us with our Facebook and Instagram pages through the University Hub Facebook page and Instagram page, or you can visit our website, the University Hub, the International University Hub.com. Have a great day, everyone. Take care.